ఉపాధి కల్పనలో ఉత్తమ ఫలితాలు సాధిస్తున్న తెలంగాణ అకాడమీ ఫర్ స్కిల్ అండ్ నాలెడ్జ్ టాస్ సీఈఓ శ్రీకాంత్ సింహతో టీవీ 5 బిజినెస్ ఎడిటర్ వసంత్ కుమార్ ప్రత్యేక ఇంటర్వ్యూను ఇప్పుడు చూద్దాం.
తెలంగాణ అకాడమీ ఫర్ స్కిల్ అండ్ నాలెడ్జ్ టాస్క్, మనందరికీ తెలుసు టాస్క్ పిల్లల్లో ఎంప్లాయబిలిటీని ఎంటర్ప్రెన్యూర్షిప్ని పెంపొందించేందుకు ఏ విధంగా ప్రయత్నం చేస్తుందో. సో టాస్క్ సీఈఓ శ్రీకాంత్ సిన్హా గారు మనతో ప్రస్తుతం ఉన్నారు. సో ఆయన అడిగి టాస్క్ ఫ్యూచర్ ఇనిషియేటివ్స్ ఏంటి, ప్రస్తుతం ఏం చేస్తుంది, ఇటువంటి అంశాలన్నీ తెలుసుకుని ప్రయత్నం చేద్దాం. నమస్తే శ్రీకాంత్ జీ, వీఆర్ హియరింగ్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ ఇనిషియేటివ్స్ దట్ టాస్క్ హ్యాస్ అండర్టేకెన్ ఇన్ ది రీసెంట్ పాస్ట్. సో వాట్స్ ది లేటెస్ట్ దట్ టాస్క్ ఈస్ డూయింగ్ టు ఎన్హాన్స్ ది ఎంప్లాయబిలిటీ అండ్ ఎంటర్ప్రెన్యూరల్ స్కిల్స్ అమాంగ్ ది యంగర్ జనరేషన్స్?
థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్. ఐ థింక్ దట్స్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫర్ అస్ టు రియలైజ్ దట్ తెలంగాణ వాజ్ అట్ వన్ టైమ్ అమాంగ్స్ ది సిక్స్త్ మోస్ట్ ఎంప్లాయబుల్ అన్ఎంప్లాయిడ్ స్టేట్ ఇన్ ఇండియా. So the Honorable Minister and the Chief Minister thought of changing it, and that's how TASC was established. Over the last couple of years, we have been focusing more on IT, ITES, because that's where the industry jobs were. But of late, if you look at it, we are running programs in aerospace engineering, we are running programs in life sciences, we will be starting programs on logistics, we will be starting programs on electronic manufacturing also. Plus, what we are looking at is this year we have also all the government polytechnics and colleges, degree colleges, have also become part of TASC itself. We are running programs. In fact, as we talk about Industry 4.0, it is important for our youth also to understand what are 21st century transferable skills. So we are running programs on 21st century transferable skills so that our youth can be prepared better for tomorrow. We are also working with more than 14 industry partners, and we are getting more and more industry partners on board, through which we are actually skilling our youth in industry-ready, relevant programs in technologies like artificial intelligence, big data, cloud, and all these where the jobs exist today. We train our youth in it so that they can become more employable.
The students are these days concerned about the job deficiency, like the jobs being taken away by these new technologies from them. So what are you doing to allay these fears from these young guys now?
That we need to realize that in future the jobs will be on the cusps. So you have agri-tech, med-techs, smart manufacturing, etc., and so on and so forth. Having said that, what we also need to understand is that apart from IT industry, there are other industries, and especially if we look at Telangana itself, a life sciences park is coming up, a logistic park is coming up. We are having so many opportunities over here. In fact, you know, if I was born today, I would like to be born in as a youth in Telangana, right, where, you know, so many job opportunities exist. And the best part over here is that the government itself is trying to run schemes. For example, like under TASC, we subsidize a lot of the education, etc., that is being provided to the youth over here. Having said that, I think one more thing that we want to do, and we have started in a small way, we run career awareness drives across the colleges. The team goes and runs career awareness drives. But I think it's important for us to reach out to the other youth that are there in the districts, etc. also. And one of our focus now moving ahead is that how do we help the underserved in the districts also get jobs? And that's where we are looking at actually going to the doorsteps. Recently, the Honorable Minister, IT Industries spoke about the IT towers coming up and where TASC could be given an office space. I think that will be our method of how we'll be able to reach out to the youth in the districts and actually train them. So we'll have a center over there where they can come and get trained on various advanced technologies, etc. Having said that, we are also working with more and more partners. We have recently, we are about to sign, in fact, on 9th, we are signing a lot of MOUs with multiple organizations to bring in the latest technologies for the benefit of our youth in Telangana. We are also part of the blockchain district, where TASC could be running the blockchain academy. In fact, probably next week, we'd be having the first set of faculty members who will be undergoing course on blockchain itself, with the help of Intel. And we'd be running those programs. So,
An institute that you are going to set up for this blockchain?
Well, the best part with us is since we have 676 colleges across Telangana, we have those many centers already existing where we can train our thing. Because what we do is we work with our colleges, we train their faculty members, and the faculty members along with us, our trainers, etc., train the other students, and that's typically how the model we work. So we will not be setting up a separate academy.
Right.
However, we have training infrastructure here in this premises itself, where we have the high-end computers, etc., which can be used for VLSI, which we'll also be running, which can also be used for blockchain and other higher-end technology.
Like you said, there's this urban-rural divide. The rural students are getting deprived of the opportunities that are available to them in the state itself, of course, leave alone the national picture. So how do you plan to make them aware of
opportunities over there? We also run programs like Mentor Talks, where we get these mentors as role models and heroes for these people. And they, the students in the rural colleges get exposed to all these various kinds of people, etc. Plus, we also have regular programs through which we are able to do technology days. So, in across Telangana, we would be having various technology days moving ahead, so that they understand what it is. We also have are partnering with different institutions who'd be able to run programs, online programs. On awareness levels on all these latest areas, be it robotics and process automation, or be it artificial intelligence or deep learning, machine learning, all these various areas. So what we are trying to do is, the other thing which I'd like to mention over here is, one of the reason why the rural youth are not able to appear in jobs is because their English language is weak. And that's where we run programs on English language itself. So we are running the business English communication programs, plus the Cambridge certification programs. We are running those programs also for the rural youth so that they can benefit and be equivalent to the youth. Having said that, I think it's important and prudent for me to mention that recently we ran under a finishing school model, a program which is called as First Day, First Hour Productivity Program, where the rural youth from the local polytechnics in Karimnagar, etc., actually came down over here. We selected them, got them down to Hyderabad, working along with the aircraft engine manufacturer Safran, created a training programs, 45 days. They were given a pre-employment offer letter saying that if they clear the program, they'll be employed. And it was a very successful model where more than 50 plus of our students have actually, from rural districts, have actually joined. And some of them have been working there for 8-9 months now, and even visited Morocco and France, sent by the organization itself. Imagine this opportunity could not have existed for the rural youth if it was not for these kind of programs.
And there are so many initiatives at the central level itself, and of course, at the state level. So, how is the collaboration between these initiatives? Like, we have NSDC, we have NSDF, and there are so many other initiatives from the central. And of course, TASC is doing its own job. So, how is the collaboration between these initiatives?
And I think if you look at it, we definitely do collaborate with sector skill councils. ESDM, for example, and others also, we collaborate with IT, ITES, etc. also. And we do run programs, but typically if we look at it, because we are not only limiting ourselves to NSQF or NSDC programs, but other programs also. Our focus is, how do we get the youth a job? And that is where we want to skill them. And there are so many gaps between what the academia, the academic institution, teaches our students and what the industry requires.
So one is, of course, the job readiness. And then what's TASC doing on the entrepreneurial skill development side?
We don't want to end up being a state of job seekers only. It's important to create a state of job givers also. And over there, what we are doing is, while V-Hub and T-Hub are creating actual entrepreneurs, we have gone more basic and said, how do we create an entrepreneur mindset? Because that's most important. It is not necessary that everyone has to become an entrepreneur today, but maybe down the line, once they have gained enough experience and understood what their call is, they can actually become entrepreneurs. And that is where we play a key part. Through various programs. Of course, we also collaborated with ISB, where we are running a program called the Technology Entrepreneurship Program. Mm-hmm. And as of date, about 170 plus people are undergoing that program. Mm-hmm. And this program has been running for 4 or 5 years. And one of the success of this programs is in terms of this air-conditioned helmet that has been created.
Yeah,
you've heard about it, yes. It's got a tremendous potential in the Middle East and other areas where temperatures are quite unforgiving. And so that is a product of our partnership and this technology entrepreneurship program. So I think it's important that we create an entrepreneurial mindset so that everyone can look at becoming an entrepreneur. And if they don't become an entrepreneur, then at least they have an entrepreneurial mindset so that organizations can also benefit from there.
Thank you, Srikanth ji. We hope TASC will join hands with TV5 and will take this career awareness and other such initiatives more to the rural and the urban areas. Skill development తో పాటు entrepreneurship మీద కూడా దృష్టి సారిస్తూ ముఖ్యంగా గ్రామీణ ప్రాంతాల విద్యార్థుల కోసం, గ్రామీణ ప్రాంతాల యువత కోసం టాస్క్ ఎన్నో ఇనిషియేటివ్స్ తీసుకుంటున్నట్లుగా శ్రీకాంత్ సిన్హా గారు చెప్తున్నారు. సో మరిన్ని టాస్క్ విశేషాలను రాబోయే రోజుల్లో అందిస్తూ ఉంటుంది టీవీ5. కీప్ వాచింగ్.